Hey PC World fans, Adam here with Gordon. And by the time you're watching this video, Gordon, we're literally in Taiwan, covering Computex. And before we go, I thought it might be kind of fun to go over kind of the gear that we're going to take to a trade show like this, because not everybody knows what it's like to go overseas, a major trade show, right. What kind of stuff do we want to bring, and this is what we're going to talk about here. We're not going to talk about everything we're taking, just some of the key stuff. So obviously what I bring is different than what Gordon brings because we kind of have different roles and responsibilities, but one of the most key things that we both need is a laptop. So Gordon, tell me about the laptop you're bringing, why you like it, you know. What you're going to be doing with it.
So this is, you see this on the show, I've used it for many years. It's an HP Dragonfly Elite. It's an older version. It's an 8th gen laptop, which I know people think is insane in a world of 13th gen. But this Dragonfly Elite is super light. It does features that I love. You know, it's a 360 design clamshell touch. It also is a commercial laptop, which I appreciate. People don't know the difference between a consumer laptop, commercial laptop. These things are just built to a higher standard. And the thing is, I've brought this thing to so many trade shows now, CES, many Computexes. It keeps rocking. And really, yeah, the bottom of it looks like hell because I've opened it up so many times. I recently swapped out the original half terabyte Optane drive. It's a combo drive. For a 2 terabyte drive, one of those deal P31 drives. But I love this laptop. I don't really need speed because all I really need is a light, something with a keyboard, and something that's reliable. And this thing is just gone to everywhere and is never let me down. So this is what I'm going to bring.
Dang, okay.
With a flat mouse.
Well, so on the opposite end, I'm always on the hunt for the best video laptop, for video editing laptop for my needs. So the laptop I'm bringing for this trip, and it changes each time, is the MSI Creator Z17HX Studio. I actually do have a separate video on this that we released a little bit ago. You can go watch that. So I'm not going to go over the details of it, but like, I'm kind of in a different camp where I'm changing laptops almost every trade show that we go to because, like, I kind of want to try out the new features and I need absolute speed and accuracy on a screen and things like that. So this is actually my first time taking a 17-inch. I feel like in the past I've mostly stuck with 15 and then more recently 16. So 17 is a little larger. So I guess, you know, I'll see if it's worth having the screen or not. I do also bring a second screen. This is a Lenovo, I don't remember what model this is, but it's a, ThinkVision M14. So a little 1080p panel. It's got a, you know, little hinge that it kind of props up on.
Yeah.
I like it. I mean, it's obviously not as color accurate as something like a video editing laptop, but, you know, this is where I'll put some, like, ancillary stuff I need off to the side, like notes or Slack or anything like that. So I need as much screen real estate as I can on the going to a trade show. And I, even though I love a full-fledged desktop or a small form factor, I'm not going to bring, you know, a separate system and a monitor and a full mouse and keyboard kind of thing. So I still like rocking laptops.
Yeah, and I used to bring second screens to shows, but I'm trying to go extremely light this year. So no monitor. I would usually bring a mechanical keyboard, reduced mechanical keyboard. Not going to bring it this year.
Well, but you do have a keyboard with you. Tell me about this.
This is
It's comical when you bring it up.
You can't even buy them anymore. I was looking. I bought this probably 10 years ago. It's a Perix made by Perixx, which is a folding keyboard, Bluetooth. This is great because I can run it on my laptop if I need to. But the main reason I bring this is if this thing fails, and again, it's never failed me before, I can use it with my phone, right?
I can
do typing on my phone. I can actually do work. I can access email on my phone with this keyboard.
Is it comfortable, though?
It's actually not bad. Among keyboards, there are some that are better. The only mistake is this escape key is too large. So sometimes, I don't know what they did. But honestly, it's been, you know, an awesome keyboard. And, you know, I've gotten, for my $25, I've gotten like 12 years of use out of it, so it's pretty handy.
Okay, I like that. Speaking of handy, as a video professional, one of the things that I need are cameras. So I actually am kind of bringing in a range of cameras that I'm going to step through here. The main workhorse right now for trade shows is the Canon C70. This thing is a beast. We used to run C100s on trade shows. For briefly, we had a C200, but the C70, I love almost everything about this damn camera. Like the one downside is the mini XLR, which is why I have to run these cables to plug the wireless mics into. But man, I'll tell you what, like this C70 has been an awesome workhorse. The size is just right. The quality you get out of it is awesome. And the lens I'm using here is the Canon RF 15-35 f.2 lens. So this is kind of the main lens we have. We have another lens that we're going to bring, which is actually attached to this one. It's the Canon RF 24-70 f/2.8. This is attached to the Canon R5C. This is mostly for stills, which you would probably say is kind of a little overkill for stills, but it also doubles as a B camera. If we need a second camera on a shoot, or if something happens to the C70, at least I know I have the R5C there as a backup. And especially with this Tascam attachment that you put in the hot shoe, then I get full access to XLR ports, which is important. So it's kind of a nice little second rig, but I mostly use it for stills on that. Speaking of stills, I'm bringing my personal camera, which is a Fujifilm X-T4. I love Fuji personally. This is definitely my jam. I use this for stills sometimes, but since I'm bringing this, this is mostly for when I like walk around Taipei and just kind of take my own personal photos. So I know it's kind of weird I'm bringing two cameras, but I prefer the Fuji.
You're bringing four
cameras. Oh, you know what? You're right. I'm bringing four cameras. So the last camera that I'm showing off here is the Sony ZV-1. This is our vlogging camera. So at the end of trade shows, sometimes it's fun to release like a behind the scenes. Here's what it was like, you know, during our trip kind of thing. So I've mixed around with the different cameras we used with this, but for CES, we mostly used this camera. It actually worked out pretty good for the most part. So I think we're gonna stick with this. I have a couple attachments like the shotgun and the hand mount and whatnot. So yeah, I got four cameras. You caught me.
Yeah, you know, cause it's funny cause I used to bring my DSLR. I've had all the 5D series. I'm not going to bring that. And then I've also slimmed down. I used to bring like a Sony Nex, which is a little consumer mirrorless camera.
Interchangeable lenses, yeah.
And I've realized every time I bring those things, I never use them. Although I kind of wish I could go to a trade show with like a 300-28 and a real camera to get the shots of, you know, and the execs holding the CPUs up or whatever. But it's just not worth it. For Computex, all I'm bringing is my phone. This is my camera. This is my recorder. So this is a Samsung S23 Ultra. Recently bought this a couple months ago, and the camera is very impressive.
Yeah,
it's a, you know,
one of the best.
It's one of the best out there. You know, the zoom is pretty awesome. So I actually kind of think I might be able to get some decent shots of the execs on stage during keynotes, and to do like, you know, blog about it or tweet about it. Where, you know, typically before, I mean, I have literally dragged an SLR with a 300 millimeter down, but it's just not worth it. So this will do it all. It's going to be my recorder. It's going to be my camera.
What do you record?
Oh, for like audio. So like I used to bring a separate audio recorder because...
Like an old journalist kind of thing, like setting down your little tape recorder.
Digital, not tape, but digital. So I actually have, you know, I would bring, you know, one or sometimes two digital recorders to have. Honestly, I'm just going to use my phone if I have to record anything. So I'm really trying to get it as light as possible this year.
Yeah. Well, I guess I'm.
Which you're not doing.
Yeah. And you know what? Maybe I'll cut out the X-T4, but we'll see. We'll see.
Nah, you'll regret it if you.
Yeah. So a couple more things. Once again, we don't need to cover everything. I'm an audio guy, so I do want to touch on audio a little bit. We bring this external Zoom recorder. It's a F4. Multi-track. This is what we use for the Full Nerd when we do the live episode of Full Nerd, which we will be doing again this year. And this is kind of fun, you know, something important to have because it's got four XLR inputs. You know, it connects to the laptop. I don't have to worry about you know, going through the camera or anything like that. So this is definitely an important piece of gear for me. But for most of the trade show, I actually use these IEMs. These are Shure. God, man, what do I have? It's a Shure 535 is what I have right now. So these are just little in-ear monitors. When I'm filming at the trade show, I need to be able to isolate the sound of what I'm actually hearing on the camera. So these have been my workhorse for a while. I like these. And actually, I tend to use these when I edit videos when I go home or to the hotel as well. So I kind of just use these all the time. I am bringing a pair of over-the-ear cans. These are the Bowers & Wilkins. Oh no, I don't remember the model number. I reviewed these for our sister channel or our sister site Tech Hive a couple years ago. I mostly use these for the plane ride actually. So the noise canceling abilities on this are awesome. So and then I can hook it up to my Steam Deck, which I'll definitely be playing on the trip, or hook it up to my phone if I want to listen to music or anything like that. But yeah, speaking of the plane ride, Gordon, what are you going to be doing on the plane ride? I'm mostly going to be playing on my Steam Deck.
Well, I'm bringing my Kindle. It's a Gen 1 paper, white, whatever they call it. It still works, so why not? I'm going to try to read that, and then I'll probably be listening to music. Since you talk about audio, I'm going to talk about audio. This is the Creative Super X-Fi, which, okay, let me break this out of here, if I can get that out.
Oh, the little dongle, okay.
A little dongle, which I love, especially on planes. And then these are, you know, fairly noise-canceling because they seal out all the sound. These are the Orvana. They're basically Creative, whatever. They're pretty decent headphones, too. So probably listening, watching, movies in the in-flight, maybe reading. That'll be it. I'm not going to play games all the way to Taipei, so...
So yeah, I mean, there's other stuff we're bringing. One thing I'm pretty excited to bring is we got this little cleaning tool at GDC this year. Puget Systems had a booth and they were giving this out, and I was like, wait, what the hell is this? And it's a little compact cleaning kit. So you've got the microfiber cloth, you got the spray all in one thing, because usually I have to bring kind of separate things. And you might be like, oh, well, why do you need this? It's because when we are there and we're shooting a demo product, a lot of the times there's been millions of other hands on that thing and it's just gunked up and smeared up, and you got to kind of clean it before you shoot it so it doesn't look good. It does look good. And I've never seen a compact solution like this, so I'm hoping it works out for me. If not, I'm going to go to Puget Systems and I'm going to get really angry. If it doesn't work. I'm not. They gave it to me for free, so.
Okay, I'm going to talk about something important is if you cover trade shows, have a good notebook. So these are classic report. This is literally your...
Yeah, it says if you show it to the camera.
This is literally...
Professional reporter's notebook.
I don't know why that, like, they just sell them on Amazon. But this is a nice one because it has a stiff backing. This is the Freebie one from CES.
2014.
And, you know, it's not as stiff. But, you know, you have a couple notebooks, a couple pens. These are Fisher, the space pen people. They're military model, very tough. And... good pens. So,
what kind of notes are you taking with your little reporter's cap? And
yeah, typically, like when people are talking and you need to take notes on if you're going over specs of a system, whatever. If we're talking about something, I need to jot down notes and look at it.
Wait, so you don't just remember all these specs off the top of your head?
I'm not Lisa Gade. So no, I have to write it down. Otherwise, I will not remember. And Lisa Gade remembers everything.
She does. But yeah, I mean, to add a little more context to this, at a trade show, we're looking at a lot of different products, and a lot of that time, where this is like we've just barely seen it for the first time 10 minutes prior to filming. So we got to get the info down. We got to regurgitate it on camera in some way that makes sense.
Right.
So
right.
We try to at least sit down before we do it after they give us the spiel and just be like, okay, Gordon, what are we going to talk about here? What's important? You know, what's the kind of hook on the video? But
right.
Yeah.
But mostly specs like this. Mostly it's specs, how many cores? Yeah. This
we're not reviewing anything because we're literally, you know, seeing it for the first time. Right. So we're just kind of covering what it is. Anything else you want to cover?
Let me think. I got the notepad. In the weird stuff, I'm bringing a CO2 meter. This is great. This is a It's actually based on a Swiss CO2 sensor, so it's actually pretty decent. I'm gonna bring a thermal imager, FLIR thermal imager. I love this one, much better than the previous models that I've used from them. And then also, as Adam has to have his Fujifilm, I'm gonna have my gamma spectrometer. You would probably call it a Geiger counter, but it's actually a gamma spectrometer. It's really cool. You can track the radiation levels on the plane or on the ground with this.
Why?
I don't know.
Okay.
There's no reason to.
Okay.
No reason
to. Yeah.
But look, it's light.
Hey, you know what? You're right.
It hooks up with my phone.
There's no reason why I need two stills cameras, but I am.
It logs to my phone, all that stuff. And then actually the last thing is I'm thinking, the first time I went to Computex, I was given advice like, oh, you don't want to let people know you're American. I don't know why. I never understood that. So at the airport,
I'm gonna have a hard time.
At the airport, I immediately bought my umbrella. This is my umbrella.
It's always the troll. He's like, oh,
I was like,
oh,
really?
I don't want people to think I'm American.
Because I know your umbrella, so I bought the American umbrella, and of course, I have my American bandana. So if they say you can't do it, you definitely don't listen to them.
Okay, that's pretty funny. Anything else you wanted to cover here?
Just the battery pack. Oh, this is my last thing.
Oh, okay, last thing.
I had to really think about, like, do I want a big, giant, 100-watt-hour battery pack?
Yeah, which I'm definitely going to bring one.
But I decided, you know, I got to go light, and I reviewed this on the website. This thing is amazing. I tried to buy one, too, but they're hard to get these days.
Who is it?
So it's made by Electjet. The what is awesome about it is based on a graphene battery.
Okay.
That means you can charge this thing at 100 watts. I'm not going to bring a 100-watt charger, but you can basically drain this thing to zero, plug it into a 100-watt charger, and it'll be full within 30 minutes.
Dang.
So, and it's light. And there's actually a different one that I brought to CES. Same, similar battery, you know, graphene batteries, charges really fast, very advanced, but it's just heavy. And I just like, I'm trying to go as light as possible.
What's the capacity of this one?
Oh gosh, I think it's only about 60 watt hours. It's not a lot. It's,
oh, okay.
It's, you know, it's enough to get the phone up. It will actually provide up to, you know, like 100 watt hours, like 100 watts out. So you can actually
run a laptop. Yeah,
you
yeah.
can actually charge your laptop with it at a decent clip too, okay. not at a very low rate.
All right. Well, thank you for covering all the stuff that you're bringing. Once again, we're bringing more than this. We just didn't want to cover everything in this video. But once again, we are currently in Taiwan covering Computex. Be sure to subscribe.
You guys forgot something.
Wait, hold up.
You forgot me.
Hey, we're bringing Willis. Willis is going to be there. Your first Computex.
My first Computex. Excited for all this.
It's going to be fun. So be sure to watch all the fun videos. Subscribe, smash the bell, all that fun stuff. Thank you, Gordon. Thank you, Willis, for coming. And thank you for watching. We will see you in the next video. Bye.